When making items such as a vase, frit, or glass that has already been pre-selected and ground into small little bits, is sprinkled onto the marbling table. The color, the shape, and the entire design of that vase has been chosen by the glassblower. He has the greatest job in the world. He gets to make what he dreams about on a daily basis. He starts that vase by getting a gather of the molten mixture on the end of the punty rod. He uses a mold to keep that beginning of the vase a consistent shape. He goes back to the furnace, gets a larger gather of glass on the end of that rod. He brings it to his marbling table, where he gently rolls it into the glass frit and picks up the excess color. Glassblower goes back to the furnace, reinserts that molten mixture on the end of the punty rod. This particular furnace holds no glass. It's just for reheating the molten mixture on the end of the rod. He goes back to his marbling table and picks up more glass. He goes back to the furnace, where he reheats that glass again. All these little bits are going to be melted on the end of his punty rod in the beginning of what will be a beautiful vase. He goes back to his table, where he rolls it back and forth on the marbling table. This helps embed all those little glass bits into the body of that vase. At times, the glass on the end of the punty rod can cool so quickly, they use a torch to reheat that glass. This helps save time. It prevents the glassblower from getting up and going to the furnace again. He uses a newspaper, a wet newspaper, to help cool the outside of that product, while the second glassblower is gently inflating the beginning of that vase. Glassblowers work as a team, and many times even in front of a crowd. We tour many folks at Kokomo Opalescent Glass. And here we go. Gravity helps the glass blowers as they work this vase. It helps stretch the vase to a particular dimension and also helps blend the colors. Again, more inflating. They step forward to a mold, which will help elongate or get the final length of what that vase is going to be. Back to the workbench. Each blown item is a work in progress. Second glass blower comes forward. He also has glass on the end of his punty rod. He attaches it to the end of the vase. Second glass blower gets the beginning of the vase. They're breaking off the sharp edges, and what once was the end is now the beginning. Where it was attached to the original punty rod is a small opening. This will be the mouth of that vase. Back into the furnace again. And now they work with slowly opening the top of that vase. Using a small paddle made of cherry wood helps guide that opening, keeps the edges soft, not sharp. Once the base is complete, again, just like all glass, no matter machine rolled or mouth blown, it must be gradually annealed.